वेलकम टू ऑल, आई एम डॉक्टर एम आर कदम, एम एस सी इन एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री एंड पी एच डी इन मटेरियल साइंस. द जूस रिसीव्ड आफ्टर क्लैरिफिकेशन इज ट्रांसपेरेंट, क्लियर एंड मोबाइल. एट दिस स्टेज दिस जूस कंसिस्ट अबाउट 85% वाटर. दिस इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड इन टू स्टेजेस. इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप this juice is concentrated to the product called a syrup which contains about 40% water, and the second concentration is carried out to the product called a massiquit. This massiquit is the semi-solid mixture of the crystalline sugar and molasses, and that contains about 9 to 11% water. The first concentration of the juice is carried out in the multiple effect evaporators. This clarified juice contains about 85% water, which is converted to the syrup, which consists about 40% water. The working of the multiple effect evaporator is based on the fact that is the boiling point of the liquid is lowered under reduced pressure. That is, in the presence of the vacuum, the concentration is carried out either in triple or quadruple effect evaporators. The triple effect evaporator used for the first concentration is shown in this figure. The each evaporator used in this triple effect evaporator is the tall vessel having 20 feet in height and 10 feet in diameter, and the neck of this evaporator is similar to that of the bottle. These evaporators are connected in series. This each evaporator divided in three chambers. This is first, this is second, and this is third. This is done by placing the two parallel plates at the bottom. This is one and this is second. This top and bottom chambers are made for the juice. These are connected by some narrow tubes and some wider tubes. The steam circulates outside these tubes and heats the juice which flowing inside these tubes. The middle chamber, that is calandria, this is made for the steam, and there is a steam inlet pipe at the middle of the calandria of the first evaporator, and the outlet of the steam of the first evaporator connected at the middle of the calandria of the second vessel, and the outlet of the steam of the second evaporator is then connected to the calandria of the third vessel, and the outlet of the steam of the third vessel is then connected to the vacuum pump. These evaporators are also connected at the bottoms through the pipes for the flow of juice from the first evaporator to the second and second to the third evaporator. During the heating, the juice admitted at the bottom of the first evaporator circulates up through the narrow tubes and circulates down through the wider tubes. During the rapid circulation of the juice causes the rapid evaporation. The steam enters in the calandria of the first vessel is partly exhausted. This steam gives its some heat to the juice and causes it to boil and evaporate. Now the same steam enters the calandria of the second vessel, which has higher vacuum. This steam has a lesser temperature, but still it causes to the juice boil and evaporate. And this same procedure is repeated in the third vessel. The vacuum, the steam temperature, and the boiling juice temperatures of the three evaporators are summarized in this table. The vacuum maintained in these evaporators in inches is first evaporator it is 3, in second evaporator it is 15, and third it is 26. The temperature of the steam entering the first evaporator in Kelvin is 381, in second evaporator 372, and in third 358, while the temperatures of the boiling juice in Kelvin at first evaporator is 372, at second evaporator 358, and at the third evaporator is 328. The advantages of this method are there is much saving of fuel because same steam is used in all evaporators, and a better product is obtained as there is boiling at relatively lower temperature, that is, there is less decomposition of the sugar, and after this concentration, syrup by this multiple effect evaporator is then pumped to the single effect evaporator, which is also called as a strike pan, for the next step, crystallization.